Hello, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Stationeers. So this is gonna be the big one. We've got our parts, and we're gonna build our workshop. Off camera, I did a little bit of mining, and of course, gathered the pieces we need. But, ended up gathering lots more oxide. I made 1,000 steel. I got some more copper, some more gold. And a lot of that's been used to build these. So we'll go over the plan. This area is going to be the foundation for the workshop. I'm not sure if I'll be able to get the entire build in a single video. This may end up being a two-parter. However, I do think I'll be able to probably get most of it. The parts in question are two stacks of steel frames, 168 steel sheets, a little bit of glass, 40 plastic, stackers, doors. It's really maybe more than we want to go over. Lots of wall kits, mostly flat walls, a few of the regular wall kits, some floor grating, some chutes, a lot of cable, various electrical parts, mostly for lighting, the airlock. And, of course, we're going to control our atmospherics with an IC chip. From the hydraulic pipe vendor, we've got a lot of pipe, as well as some radiators, atmospherics kit, various pumps and pressure regulators. I usually prefer to go through the parts list in a little more detail, but that's a lot of parts. So, first thing we gotta do is we gotta finish clearing off this ground. Should be easy enough. Okay. That should be enough space. The initial plan is for a 7x8 grid space. The building itself will be 6x7. I think. No. 5x6. Go ahead and get that foundation laid out. Okay, that leaves us 5 frames, which will form the front wall. This is going to be constructed very similar to the greenhouse, where the front wall of the building is made up of frames and the rest is just wall segments. Before we fill that in, let's clean up this over here a bit. Better go ahead and get another battery. So we're going to leave this row open. That'll be our walkway. Doorway will go here. Alright, so I think the next thing to do will be go ahead and get our doors in place. No, let's do our power connection. This one will be the airlock. I may move that later. Oh, that's unfortunate. Let's move some of this around. Keep that there in case we need that space. So, in my original build, when I tested this out, I basically just ran a power line all the way around the building, and that gave me plenty of places I could tap into. So, I think we'll do that again. Okay. That took less cable than I expected. We might go ahead and set up the basics of the airlock just so we can get these doors powered. That's a pretty good start. Now, I have decided I want to do this in blue. Let's go ahead and get our paint. No particular reason other than I just like the blue. And a couple of other things I do know that I want. Windows here on either end. I'm going to go ahead and get those in place. Go have a drink and I'll come back and plumbing for this airlock. Okay, let's get that airlock finished. Gonna need some pipe, pressure regulators. Cable. Where are my tools? Okay. So just like with the airlock at the greenhouse, we're going to have pressure regulators to keep the airlock plumbing charged so that it can refill the airlock chamber quickly. Bring this down a little bit so I can work with it better. So this pressure regulator is going to charge this line through the passive vent, pulling atmospheric gases in from inside the workshop into this line. And then we'll have a back pressure to bleed off excess pressure so we don't blow up the lines. And then those pipes will form the actual pressure vessel. Set the back pressure at 6,000 or 6 megapascals. And the pressure regulator will charge that line 5 megapascals. That should give us plenty of pressure to refill this chamber. Okay. We're not gonna set this up yet, because we want to be able to just really walk through these doors. Need more cable. Go ahead and turn these on. Nothing for them to pump right now, but if I seal up the wall later.
Jetpack on.
And of course, we've got to hook up that APC as well, which I may have to move over. Well, I don't know. Get a battery. I think we'll use this one. All right. think the next system we'll look at is the suit storage. Gonna live right there. We can't set it up yet though because we don't have our atmospheric yet. Maybe our next move is bringing our plumbing over. Yeah, let's do that. Forgot I had this battery. Okay. Somewhat our atmospheric mix. Pretty good start.
Yeah.
Okay, that's got them brought over, but we have one other. Waste return as well. Those are there and ready to use. We're also going to have to bring over water. That's where we want our water in. Speaking of water, let's hydrate and we'll come back and do some more. Well, now that we've got our plumbing brought over, we need to start working on the actual structure itself. Color sorted. What I want, but that's not how I want it. There we go. ceiling is going to be. There we go. That looks nice. Open those up. Do a few of these and this. That's where I want that. I end up moving that. Now, at this point, it's worth pointing out that this is a mostly enclosed space. It's still open to the vacuum right here, but if I do any spray painting or welding, particularly with the chemical welder, that will produce or introduce chemicals into this area that may take some time to be removed. So, at this point, from this point forward, we should always do any spray painting or welding outside spray painting. The welding, it doesn't really matter because of the arc welder. Now that that's in place, let's look at our lighting. Our light switch is going to be right here. And our lights are going to be along the center line. Yeah. I think we want to bring our power for the lights around here, around this way. May end up having to reroute this. Okay, so we've got a switch, a logic reader to read that switch, and a batch writer to write the state of that switch to all of those lights. That will write to all lights long angled, and it will write to the on property. Let's see if it works. There we go. That's lighting sorted. Next thing we want to do is plumb in our Atmo mix. So we need a pressure regulator and some passive vent. I gotta get this pipe analyzer too. So khaki is our Atmo mix color. Blue is our decorative color. These are going to be our inputs for the nitrogen-oxygen mix, the Atmo mix. Can't paint that until it's in place. This pipe analyzer is going to give us our info on our temperature and gas makeup inside the building. Could have grabbed a pipe too. Here we go. Now, just like with the greenhouse, this pipe analyzer is not going to have the correct amounts because it'll only show us what's in the pipe. But it will have the correct pressures and ratios and temperatures. See, thought I might have to reroute that. Now, I could intersect that with a pipe, no problem. I don't like the way it looks. It bugs me. I'm gonna have to cross that pipe. That's all right. To avoid crossing. Yeah, it's silly and it's inefficient, but it makes me happy. Some water in a pipe. All right. I think the next step will be to set up our CO2 removal system. So Let's go ahead and get that pumped in. Gonna go in the corner right here. Now, what we take out, the CO2, it's going to be sent back to the waistline, which will also join the suit storage. And what we keep here, then we're just going to send it right back to these lines. Need more pipe. Crossing pipes, but Now, unfortunately, this is one of the flaws in this system. When we get to the atmospheric controls code, we'll go over it a bit more, but basically, once we reach a certain level of CO2 in the Atmo inside, this filtration system will kick on and filter out all of the CO2. Unfortunately, these filtration units are very powerful, so while it's not on for a very long time, while that system is on, there's a great deal of airflow inside there. It's not hazardous, but it is annoying. I probably need to come up with some system to buffer that somehow. But for now, this is what we've got. Since we're here, we may as well go ahead and get the suit storage waistline hooked up. I think that will work. I may have to reroute that. Nitrogen and oxygen lines for suit storage systems can get a little crowded. Well, I guess since we're here, we can go ahead and get the suit storage hooked up. This volume pump needs to be here to carry the waste away. This too. No, that's a backbreaker. This pressure regulator will be used to work with the atmospheric system to replenish oxygen that has been converted to CO2 and then removed by the filter. These two regulators will control the pressure going into the suit storage to replenish oxygen and jetpack propellant. I have enough. That's not gonna work. Well, we'll have a drink and come back and clean this up. Okay, let's grab this bit of pipe over here. Some cable.
Jetpack on.
on. Data line. Yeah, I think that'll work. That seems to be working just fine. Think we're almost ready to pressurize. Seal some things up. Guess we need to set up the airlock. Probably seal that up. This airtight. I'm gonna have to reach out that pipe. We'll do that while this fills. Let's see how it looks. Yeah. That's all right. Interior walls, we've got our lighting, suit storage is set up, we are adding atmospheric gas, filtration's ready to go, airlock set up. I think we might call it here. Next time, come back in, set up our atmospheric controls, get our furnishings in here, and this place ready to roll. But for now, let this fill, and guess I'll catch you guys next time. Thank you for watching.